let me now set the context for this 24 days long Self-Actualized Leaders Network Global Summit 2021 so that we all can come on the same page. So for those who have no idea about what Project Uparivartan is, let me quickly give you a glimpse of what it is. Project Uparivartan is world's largest project ever taken in this Chaturyugi cycle, which is launched by Defined Values Consultants for reforming the entire world towards the golden age. We have envisioned the transition of humanity, the world, and the universe into the next yuga as per the eternal cosmic cycle described in the book Code of Citizens' Conduct, Rashtradhar. Just like the day and night cycle and the cycle of the seasons, we have a cycle of collective human consciousness also, which makes a pattern which get converted into clues and picked by high conscious people towards reaching to this seed of yada yada hi dharmasya, because all those souls who would reach to their maximum potential will have only this mission, the mission to fix all defects of collective human consciousness. Yada yada hi dharmasya, that means whenever and wherever, in any space and time, if there is a decline in value system, which means people lose their self-actualization state, the self-actualized and other self-actualized and self-realized souls get this clue that time for a grand change has come. And it is exactly the same time. We are very fortunate to witness this firsthand and not just read that in the history. Of course, we are reading previous Project Uparivartan in history, but this Project Uparivartan, which is history in the making, you can witness that live. Now, as this is a SALN Global Summit, let me just quickly introduce you to the Self-Actualized Leaders Network or Leadership Network. Self-actualization is a state of self-awareness from where a person can take highly effective decisions and becomes a visionary thinker. At a self-actualized state of mind, a person's observations reach very close to the root reason for the problem. At this stage, the latent potential of the human being manifests into optimum performance. As a matter of fact, very few people of the world achieve actualization of their potential, resulting in an acute leadership shortage in almost all institutions today. So if this self-actualized potential is not activated, it remains latent and go wasted throughout the life, resulting into ineffectiveness of quality of service of this ecosystem. Self-Actualized Leaders Network, or SALN, is a collaboration platform of self-actualizing leaders from all domains to come together and resolve all problems of the world from the root through a collaborative effort. Now, about Self-Actualized Leaders Network Global Summit 2021. It's a spectacular event to bring several eminent speakers, thought leaders, visionaries, and luminaries together to integrate all 17 United Nations Sustainable Development Goals with the Project Uparivartan Synergy Platform, with an aim to unite the humanity as one family, one country, one workplace, and one philosophy. And to achieve this, we have diagnosed that these 17 goals are not sufficient unless we add one more goal to it, which is goal zero, self-actualization of all leaders. About the organizers, the team behind organizing this event, the Self-Actualized Leaders Network Global Summit 2021 is organized by Defined Values Consultants, which aims to develop Bharat into a Vishwaguru country by decoding the ancient wisdom and deriving, developing, and propagating the contemporary formats and frameworks of human and organizational development in front of the world. The event partners for this event are CRDG Foundation, Opulence Group, and the Research Foundation of India. All of them are collaborating through Project Uparivartan Synergy Platform. The event is spread across 4 months, as you all know, 18th July to 23rd July, then 18th August to 23rd August, 18th September to 23rd September, and 18th October to 23rd October, from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. on all 24 days. The 23rd of every month is kept for candid interaction of Chief Mentor Hitesh Chandel with audience and speakers. So if you have any questions during the summit or about Project Yug Parivartan or SALN or any entity associated with the system, the 6th day of every month, that is 23rd, is kept reserved for that straight question and answer. So you can come and you can ask any question which comes from your curiosity. Themes of the events in the month of July are like this. Day 1, 18th of July, the theme is Introduction to United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. Day 2, 19th July, the theme is Goal 0, Self-Actualization of All Leaders. Day 3, 20th July, Goal 1 of UNSDG, No Poverty. Day 4, 21st July, Goal 2, Zero Hunger. Day 5, 22nd July, Good Health and Well-Being, which is goal number 3 of UNSDG. Then day 6, 23rd July, Candid Conversations with Chief Mentor Hitesh Chandel. In the month of August, which is day 7 on 18th August, we will cover goal 4, Quality Education. On day 8, 19th August, we will cover Gender Equality, goal 5. Day 9, 20th August, Goal 6, Clean Water and Sanitation. Day 10, 21st August, Goal 7, Affordable and Clean Energy. Day 11, 22nd August, Goal 8, Decent Work and Economic Growth. And Day 12, again, 23rd August, as a candid conversation with Chief Mentor Hitesh Chandel. Similarly, Day 13 is Goal 9, Industry, Innovation and Infrastructure. Day 14 is Goal 10, Reduced Inequalities. Day 15 is Goal 11, Sustainable Cities and Communities. Day 16 is Goal number 12, Responsible Consumption and Production. Day 17, 22nd September, Climate Action, Goal number 30. And on Day 18, 23rd September, we will again have a candid conversation with Chief Mentor Hitesh Chandel. In the month of October, the concluding month, Day 19, 18th October, Life Below Water, Goal number 14. Day 20, goal number 15, life on land. Day 21, goal number 16, peace, justice, and strong institutions. Day 22nd, goal 17, partnerships for the goals. Day 23, on 22nd October, we will have summit closing ceremony. And day 24, again, candid conversations with Chief Mentor Hitesh Chandel on 23rd October. Now, in these 24 days, we will give a particular topic, a particular goal, UNSDG, to every speaker, and they have to speak on that. So every speaker has to talk about the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals allocated to them. Following points should ideally be covered in their presentation. In your opinion, do we need a grand change in the governance and constitutions of the world, or the world is just doing fine and big reforms are not required? So they have to cover that in their presentation. What three things you think should change for the ecosystem to become a golden age ecosystem? What is your vision of golden age or an ideal world? Describe your mission of life and how United Nations Sustainable Development Goals are related to your mission. What is your understanding about the UNSDG allocated to you? And what is your observations about shortcomings in design and implementation by the United Nations? Additionally, there are more questions. What have you already contributed so far to accomplish your mission? Just a status update. What is your take on the role of business organizations in creating a golden age ecosystem? What is your take on the role of a common man in creating the golden age? What are the strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats that you feel for your mission? How do you see your vision converging with Project Yug Parivartan vision? And what help do you seek from Project Yug Parivartan Synergy platform to empower your vision? Some guidelines for speakers, because we are creating a holistic system for the entire world. So we have to be very clear that it is an inclusive, exclusive, and conclusive vision to unite the humanity into one family, one country, one workplace, and one philosophy. And hence, we need to take extra precautions not to offend anyone. We want everyone on this planet to be in Project Uparivartan. So avoiding degenerating words towards any caste, creed, language, political affiliations, religion, or country. All the speakers would be eminent speakers, and hence we would like to invite a speaker at his or her scheduled time only and avoid any delay in start of the next speaker's speech. Hence, it is important that every speaker must end his session in time. And we have allocated 30 to 45 minutes to each invited speaker, which includes reading of their introduction by the anchor and comment or vote of thanks by the moderator.